Hey, what is up guys, and welcome back once again to another Fallout 4 settlement build. Today we're going to be checking out the diner, which is a build I've wanted to do for a very long time. And I gotta say, even though we didn't have all that much room, we were still able to pack a lot of detail into the space we had. But in the end, I can honestly say I really do enjoy how this one turned out, so hopefully you guys do as well. But without further ado, let's go ahead and get a closer look. Alright guys, so now we'll go ahead and take a closer look at the outside of the build, which arguably does look quite a bit different from most of the other ones in this town. I can honestly say it does have much less of a Western style, but as I've mentioned a lot in the past, a good bit of variety never hurt anyone, so I think for now, this building is going to stay the way it is. However, that being said, there are still, you know, a couple unnecessary offices and whatnot for the owner in the second floor, so if we ever really wanted to give this town a very set style, we could, I guess, eventually end up changing this one up and making it a bit more Western. Therefore, although it may be very different from a lot of the other builds in this town, I still think it has a place here in the end. But yeah, on the outside here, you can see there's quite a bit of advertising. I mean, come on, there's three diner signs. You know, in reality, all you would need is one. But this place is really trying to pull in customers because maybe times are tough or something. But other than that, there's some other cool knickknacks around here. And probably my favorite thing is this yellow sign here, which reads, clothing optional beyond this point. And you know, there's also some of the more common things like the open sign, which although it may be seen as very simple, I think it still gives the build a bit more of a restaurant feeling. But originally going into this build, I wanted to give it sort of a 1950s retro diner style. And I think it still has a little bit of that, but as time went on, it really picked up more of a, I guess if you've lived in the United States before or are currently living there, you may have been to one of those truck stop diners that's really almost in the middle of nowhere. But when you go into these types of places, they're always the coolest thing because they've got just loads and loads of posters and pictures and a lot of cool memorabilia just scattered all across the walls. So instead of looking like a 1950s retro diner, this one looks a bit more like a truck stop one. But although that's not what I was originally going for, I think it definitely fits the whole style of this town quite a bit more, so I gotta say, I'm definitely happy with how it turned out. Now moving on to the inside, unlike a lot of our other buildings, this one has sort of one big giant central room, whereas a lot of the other ones are kind of broken up into several separate rooms. And I can honestly say it's a lot easier to decorate those smaller rooms one at a time, so having this one big giant open area was a bit overwhelming at first, but I think in the end it was kind of a nice challenge, and by the time I was done, I think the amount of detail we ended up with was just about right. And although the first floor is pretty much one big giant room, I still tried to divide it just a little bit to make it seem like maybe the area off to the left was a bit more private or intended for families to use, and then also to make it seem as if the area over to the right was definitely a lot more open, and I tried to make it seem like it was a bit more inviting towards a rowdier bunch. But throughout the whole build, you'll see all the walls are completely covered with these posters and whatnot, and there's even a lot of memorabilia, such as this baseball gear here, and also a camera, which you could possibly imagine still contains pictures from before the war, possibly of a baseball game or something. And other than that, there's also some more common things that you would really see in just about every restaurant, such as the jukebox here and, you know, some menus and whatnot scattered around. But I also tried to give this area a bit more style, so that's why you see some more crazy things like the little rocket ship thing back here along with some toy cars and whatnot. And although that may be a little bit kooky, I think in the end it really does give this restaurant quite a bit more style. And last but not least, we'll go ahead and check out the kitchen area, which is also where the bar and a couple booths are as well. But overall, as you can see, I really tried to jam-pack this area with as much detail as possible. And as tedious as it may have been placing down each and every fork, I can honestly say in the end, I think it really did pay off. But you know, out of our buildings, we do have some that are a bit more on the happy side, and others that are intentionally designed to be, I guess, a bit more menacing or gloomy. And I was thinking, since our bar was a bit more On the gloomy side, I really wanted this one to have much more of a happier feeling. And I think out of all the places you could choose to work at in the wasteland, this one here would definitely be a bit more on the enjoyable side. But I guess then again, that would kind of depend on the types of customers you would get here and whatnot. But anyways guys, like I said earlier, the upstairs pretty much just contains a couple office rooms and an area for, you know, workers to clean up at, which I'm sure you guys have seen plenty of already. I mean, just about every single one of our other builds have had something along those lines, and today I really just wanted to show you something unique, and in the end, just the diner portion of the build. So that being said, that'll do it for today, guys. Hopefully you did enjoy today's build. Go ahead and let me know what you guys thought down in the comments below, and also if you have any ideas for future builds or even improvements we could make to this one, please feel free to let me know those as well. But yeah, once again guys, thanks for watching. Hopefully you did enjoy the build, and as always, I will see you in the next one.